We now place ourselves in the loving presence of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the heart of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your spirit and they shall be created and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in His consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Some Pharisees and Herodians were sent to Jesus to ensnare him in his speech. They came and said to him, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you are not concerned with anyone's opinion. You do not regard a person's status, but teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not? Should we pay or should we not pay?" Knowing the hypocrisy, he said to them, "Why are you testing? Bring me a denarius to look at." They brought one to him and said to them, "Whose image and inscription is this?" They replied to him, "Caesar's." So Jesus said to them, "Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." They were utterly amazed at him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good afternoon, good morning, and good evening. The Lord be with you.
Good evening, afternoon.
There is this hypocritical question to Jesus. But Jesus answered in the manner that he is, and according to him, pay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. Yes, there are many ways of the government. There are many ways of the state. There are many ways of the language of the people, so much so that the people are really asked to pay taxes. For one, we are called to pray for our government leaders. Praying for them, it means to begin their life together with us and for all. So much so that this contribution we call taxes, it is our duty to give them. Well, of course, other governments are using it formally. Others are using it for other things. But the truth is, our role is to support the government in all its actions, to pray for them, in order that they partake in the sovereignty of God. Not praying for them, well, you know, many other states or nations, that they are not praying for their government. They simply behold their government or whatever, but not praying for them. And so what happened is that they enact laws that are against humanity. But for us, it's still nice to bring to our government what we have, to bring to our government the things that we own in order for them to be acknowledged. An acknowledgement of the government should be with regard to the purpose of the law. And the law is for the human nature, human persons, to persevere, to act according to the law of God. So therefore, praying for them and paying taxes for them is what Jesus is trying to say. Pay to Caesar what is due to Caesar. Pay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. And now to God what belongs to God. Of course, we have our government. But according to our theme, according to our religion, and precisely because of religion, whether you are a Catholic, whether you are a Baptist, a Protestant, it depends on where you are. Pero as Catholic, we give to the Lord what belongs to the Lord. Sunday Mass, for example, that belongs to the Lord. The sacraments that belongs to the Lord. other things, our novenas, they, although they are private, but they belong to the Lord as partakers of that inhabitant of the Lord. And so we give to the Lord what is truly of God. We give to God what belongs to Him. We give to Him all that is necessary for Him. It's not that, that we add the greatness of the Lord because He's already great. But our prayer is for us to go to Him and to Him, to the Father, to Jesus and to the Father. And so the beauty of giving back to God what belongs to God makes us in or enables us to practice the redeeming gift of the Lord. Many times we are here on this earth, but we know it depends on the government that we have. But precisely in the United States, I guess, they have to pay their taxes. In the Philippines, you know, you have to, to keep it at times. But of course, along the way, along the run, we are acknowledged to be as such. Therefore, all the things that we are doing is in view of that. So to Caesar, what is due to Caesar, and to God, what is due to God. We pray, we support our government, and then we pay our taxes. And to God, we belong to the Lord. And so therefore, the sacraments, the Bible, all the things that are given to us are for our own sake. Let us not be people who wish that everything would be okay, even if we are not paying. But let us be people who are there, who are praying much, who are paying much for the glory of God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you for this privilege you have given.
Thank you for this privilege you have given.
To pay to Caesar what is due to Caesar's. And to God what belongs to God.
And to God what belongs to God.
You called us, Lord. To support our government.
To pray for them, and therefore
to pay our taxes,
for the common good,
and at the same time,
you want
us to give to God.
What belongs to God.
We are your people, O Lord.
And we want to recognize you for that.
So that it will embody the Spirit of Christ in us, and for everybody.
Thank you, O Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Angel of God, my guardian dear, whom God's love commits me here, ever this day be at my side, to light and guard, to rule and guide. Saint Hannibal,
pray for us. Saint Anthony, pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
O Lord, your holy apostles in the church.
We continue to pray for Tita MJ so that she will have his healing, her healing, and that all will go up for the glory of God and for our good. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good morning. Good morning. Good afternoon. Welcome, Potita.
There's so, any question for Father?
Question or question?
Dito sa US, Father, we cannot get rid of our taxes whether we like it or not.
Yeah, compulsory. Mm-hmm.
Yes, compulsory.
So, hindi pwede makatago.
Hindi but pwede, no? Mm-hmm.
But then it goes up and up and up. Diyos ko.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But they help, you know, makita mo ang mga tax money is for the good of each and every citizen.
Yes.
Kaya lang. Marami naman kasi ang income ng US, kaya mm-hmm. something else nag-ano din sila, nag-provide ng help in one way or another. So, still to glorify God.
Very good. Hey, US, walang problema eh. You have everything.
Kaya ang daming gustong pumunta ba?
Dito, if you pay your taxes.
Yeah.
So, ang US is the one place na privileged by God ba.
Mm-hmm.
We have all the resources, we have the knowledge and skills and talents of the people for the modernization of the whole humankind. So let us continue to pray lang no for that these leaders no will be Christ centered and you know they will rule the land, the nation with fear of the Lord.
We pray ba? We pray that the Lord will give us a leader. Yung i-enlighten niya kung sino ang gusto niya maging leader. Kasi right now, chaotic tayo.
Chaotic, ho. Just like if we read the thought of the day ni Ricky, if our leaders become like, the way they rule, no, the nation, if our leaders, and then it's against our faith, I mean, how can we really respect them? Just like here in the US, no, we have the privilege of having a lot of resources, material things, everything, you name it, we have it here. Kaya lang, ang ano naman dyan is, on the other hand naman, they support, may marami dito na nag-support ng abortion, mga same-sex marriage, mga euthanasia, tapos yun, to name a few. Especially ang mga ang war ba. So,
yeah, that's why we have to pray for our government, whatever kind of government they are, we have really to pray in order for them to do the will of God. Kasi if we are not praying, kasi we don't like them, it's also our responsibilities. So to all government leaders, we have really to pray and to ask God to lead them to what their actions should be.
Because there's no perfect leader. There's no perfect leader talaga.
Yeah, very true.
But
very
they have
true.
they have all the potentials to do good.
Yeah.
They have all the potentials.
But hindi pwede na, hindi ko yung party, hindi ko yung papa, hindi ko pagdasal. Hindi pwede yun.
Hindi pwede. Yeah,
otherwise, ikaw, papartihan ka na rin ni Lord.
So, kahit na dyan sa Philippines, imagine, no, nakapas ng, let's talk about divorce dyan, no? 85% or 90% Christians, no, and yet, and then I don't know how many percent ang Catholic dyan. Kasi ang Christians
85.
So yata, 85.
80 to 85.
And yet, kung bakit nakapasa ang abortion sa Congress.
Divorce.
Ang divorce, oo. I'm sorry, ang divorce, bakit nakapasa sa Congress?
Hindi pa naman, yun, hindi pa naman nakaano sa Senate eh. Unless na evito
kaya
ni...
Kaya nga, isang ano lang yan sa... The first time yata yan na nakapasa sa third reading sa Congress, ang divorce.
Yes.
No, the first
alam mo naman, congressmen and congresswomen have their own different views. Many are liberals. Many do not like perhaps their own marriage. That's why they would like to have it. But then Catholics and real Catholics should abide. Should abide with our sacramental union.
Yeah. When we pray, no, we pray for all the leaders of the world. Not only kapartido mo. So.
Father.
Brother, yes, po.
If there is no divorce in the church.
No divorce talaga in the church.
How can they have this divorce even if it is approved?
What do you mean if there is no divorce in the church?
Yeah, paano sila mabibigyan ng divorce? How can they avail of that divorce?
The divorce is not with the Catholic. The divorce is for the government.
Civil divorce, siguro 2 months.
Yes.
Hindi sa
church. Yeah, it is the civil.
Civil divorce.
So
marriage in the government.
If both of them are Catholics, they cannot avail of that.
They can avail of the government divorce, but they could not avail still of the nullification of the marriage vows. Kasi dalawa po yun eh, government and the church. Kami, yeah. We represent both the government and the church. So there is the marriage of the government, there's the marriage of the church, kahit kami na mga pati nag-solemnize ng marriage nila.
It's a big challenge, no? Sa Catholic Catholic faith. Just
well,
in case.
I think the next step would be to put expiry date on marriage.
No.
Yeah.
If you put expiration with that, although ako tinatanong ko yan pag nagsasign ng contract, sabi ko, how many years you want it? But they will say always forever, Father.
Pag nag-expire, di pwede na mag-divorce.
Ano yan, pagkain? May expiration.
The divorce is for the government. For the divorce, it's the divorce is for the government really, and not for the Catholic Church. But in the Catholic Church, at times they get the divorce, but they could not marry. They could not marry sa atin. But of course, if they will marry, they will commit adultery. They will commit mortal sin.
Yeah.
I see.
Oh, but Father. Legally separated. Parang divorce na kasi you are legally separated eh, and you can marry again. Diba?
No, you can't.
So
no,
like
you
divorce.
Can't.
No.
Hindi
pa rin. Kasi you have still the marriage vows. Legally lang eh.
You cannot marry.
Legally separated, can marry?
No.
Yun nga. That I'm asking.
Hindi pwede.
When you get married, you will commit adultery.
Yes, Potita. You are married already. And if you get married, that's adultery.
Kailangan pala i-push.
Father Danny, I have a question.
Yes, Potita.
I've read something about fiducia supplicante, which was forwarded to me by a friend from a certain group, from Synod.
and he is a lawyer. Mm-hmm. And there was a statement there that Pope Francis is a traitor because he condones fiducia supplicante. So I asked him, what is fiducia supplicante? It has something to do with the LGBT, that it was accepted in the church that he is, that all the priests, whoever comes to the church, will bless these people living the kind of life which is not in the Bible, as Father in Heaven had created. And I have had defended the Pope Francis that he must have had misunderstood this statement, because I've read also on the side of Bishop Socrates that what Pope wants is that we cannot tolerate the sin, but we accept the person who comes to the church. It doesn't mean that when he comes to the church, he shouldn't be blessed. Everybody is blessed, and despise these people or shun away from these people who are LGBT. These people does not follow what God wants them to be, isn't it, Father?
I go for your second interpretation that they should be blessed. In fact, you know, when the Pope says I accept homosexuality, it means as persons they are accepted, they are blessed, and that their blessing hopefully will turn into God's grace to become new.
Yeah,
I see.
It should be for their newness, and not the blessing that we are encouraging.
I see. Yes, as a person, they are blessed.
Yes.
Yes, but not their sin, the act that they did.
Well, yeah, their sins are their sins, so they can go and confess that one. It's not about us to take care of their sins. But of course, as people, we have to draw them back to the Lord.
Oh, yes. I understand now.
Condemn the sin, not the sinners.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you,
it's
Father.
It's a difficult situation nowadays because almost all countries are having this one. So, I don't know what would happen really, but we pray that, example, for our faith, it will be our faith still. We will persevere in our faith. We will be faithful in our faith amidst all the trials and tribulations.
I understand now.
Okay.
Thank you, Father. Yes.
Welcome. Okay. So all of us have the dimensions to become children of God. Whatever we are, whoever we are, wherever we are, all in the name of the Lord, that we will follow Him. So let us avoid the evil. Let us avoid sin. Let us avoid all those things that are inimical to God. And therefore, let us be of Jesus. Amen.
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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Thank you po.
Bye.
Thank you very much, Father.
Bye-bye po.
Bye, love you, Father.
Yun ang problema po.
Bye-bye, Father.
Ang problema, Father.
Please go ahead. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon po. I mean, good evening po dyan sa inyo. Bali, yung ma-share ko sa gospel ngayon is that Jesus is making us clear, no? What is our choice, our priority? So, He wants us to choice, to have a choice between the two, or the world or God, no? or yes, mamili tayo kung saan ang gusto natin. But hindi naman niya dininay, he did not deny our obligation, the authority. Give what is due to Caesar. Eh kung hindi ka magbayad ng taxes, paano naman ma-improve yung land mo, yung iyong province or yung city? No? Obligation tayo po na dapat natin i-fulfill, no? Kami nga sister, babayad din kami ng mga taxes namin, lalo na pag mag-process ng mga papers ng mga what's this? I experienced that when I was in the Philippines, no? What's this? Yung mag-process ka ng papers, permit ng school, you have to pay. Kahit na hindi naman sabi na may ano, magbayad talaga ng ano kasi we are exempted, no? Exempted of the... But we have to pay. We have to follow the what is being asked of us from the government. Okay. Next, yung ating ano, yung ating what's this? Yung ating income tax. Naalala ko noon, nag-work pa ako. Government pa ako. Nagbabayad din ako ng tax kahit maliit lang yung sweldo. Pero imagine ka, no? Babawasan pa yung sweldo mo. Just to, the Lord encouraged us, no? Na-encourage us na to do our obligation. But yung gawa niya is that you have to pay what is what to give, what is for, what is due to the government, what is due to our land. Then we have to give also what is for God. Sometimes, pinutan ng petition na it's not yung ating pagsamba. Hindi naman siguro inaano na kasi even in the first Christians, no, meron silang collection, ini-encourage yun kasi how could the community could live without the help of the people. Yeah, marami din po na na-touch, no? They have to give. Then no, unknowingly, marami mang babalik naman yun sa'yo eh. Graces of the Lord is cannot be seen. No? Cannot be seen with our naked eyes. Good health, peace of mind and heart. So yung blessings ng family. The family is intact. The family is together. That is a blessing. Pero, kaya nga sabi ko, sometimes makalimutan na meron din tayong obligation sa Panginoon na we have to help the church. Yun po. No? Kung nagbibigay po tayo, yun yung ating ano kay Lord. Lord, this is for you. Yung nagbibigay tayo for the help of the orphans, the help sa mga poor. Lord, this is for you.
For healthcare run by the government to maintain peace and order in the community. Yun.
Okay. Kami as a religious, no? As a community na lang kasi ako, wala naman talaga kami taxes. We have our own taxes. When we process our documents, we have to pay. Pay really. No? Lahat mga documents namin, we have to pay. So, yun po yung obligation between God and our country. And yun lang po, ma-share ko sa inyo that when we do, salamat tita. Amen po.
Thank you, sister.
Lord God, thank you for your abundant love and care for us. Please fill us with your wisdom and compassion. May you bless us with your never-ending love. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And all together, please, glory be to the Father,
to the Son, to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Amen. Amen. Thank you all.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.